Radical change in beliefs is helping a Fort Myers man shape the future of our children.
He was raised to believe in communism until a defining moment changed everything. NBC2's Annalise Garcia continues our celebration of Hispanic Heritage Month with this story.
His father was a founding member of the Puerto Rican Communist Party. Now, Ismael Hernandez has created an organization that creates programs within schools to teach children about their freedoms.
I call myself a red diaper baby.
Marxism and propaganda.
That America was the enemy of the human race, and it was our duty to destroy America.
It was all he knew.
I grew up in a communist household.
At the age of 8, Ismael Hernandez was selling communist propaganda on the streets of Puerto Rico. By 12, he was listening to 8-hour speeches by dictators like Fidel Castro.
Como profeta de la revolución.
And at 17, he followed in his father's footsteps.
Eventually, I joined the party with him.
For years, he says the FBI followed his father because of his communist activity.
So they thought we were spies, that we were conspiring to end the American presence in Puerto Rico. And it's true, we were.
But at 25 years old, Hernandez moved to Mississippi for school.
So you can imagine this black Puerto Rican boy who hates America lands in Dixie.
He started reading the kinds of books he had never been exposed to before.
That's Yankee propaganda. You stay away from that.
With information like nothing that he'd been taught.
And things were not exactly as my father used to say. My lungs were filled with the breath of freedom when I came to America. And I rejected Marxism and socialism as false.
After school, he ended up in Fort Myers, fully embracing democracy.
Yes.
He founded the Freedom and Virtue Institute, educating children and adults in poor and minority communities about their freedoms.
We do it by showing them simple, practical ways of meeting their needs through work.
All the money that we make, yeah, we'll basically go to us.
Hernandez tells me his goal is to show people in poverty how not to be dependent.
Because if I'm a poor person and you tell me you're gonna take care of me, I'll let you.
Like making their own products to sell.
We don't introduce new activities. We redefine existing activities that are already happening in the schools that have entrepreneurial potential.
Teaching self-reliance.
And that is teaching the kids that, you know, they are capable of getting out of poverty by their own effort.
And giving them a taste of freedom.
And once you taste that, you don't want dependency.
Hernandez says his father died as a communist in his 90s, with the FBI following him until his death. But even though their beliefs were different, he credits his father with making him the man he is today.
Don't be a fence sitter, he told me. If that's what you say you believe, you better fight for it, because that's what he did.
The Freedom and Virtue Institute conducts three unique causes: the Self-Reliance Club, Dignity of Work, and the Effective Compassionate Training Program. The group is involved in 16 area schools and has a presence in 8 other states and the Dominican Republic. Live in the studio tonight, I'm Annalise Garcia, NBC.